Good morning. King Jehoiakim burned the scroll with God's word. What was God's reaction? So we're again at Jeremiah chapter 36, and we're going to read now from verse 27 to 32. Now, after the king had burned the scroll with the words which Baruch had written at the instruction of Jeremiah, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah, saying, take yet another scroll and write on it all the former words that were in the first scroll which Jehoiakim, the king of Judah, has burned. And you shall say to Jehoiakim, king of Judah, thus says the Lord, you have burned this scroll, saying, why have you written in it that the king of Babylon will certainly come and destroy this land and cause man and beast to cease from here? Therefore, thus says the Lord concerning Jehoiakim, king of Judah, he shall have no one to sit on the throne of David, and his dead body shall be cast out to the heat of the day and frost of the night. I will punish him, his family, and his servants for their iniquity, and I will bring on them, on the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and on the men of Judah, all the doom that I have pronounced against them, but they did not heed. Then Jeremiah took another scroll and gave it to Baruch the scribe, the son of Neriah, who wrote on it at the instruction of Jeremiah all the words of the book which Jehoiakim, the king of Judah, had burned in the fire, and besides, there were added to them many similar words. Friend, how gracious God is to send us his insight, his warnings in his word. And it's even more gracious when he comes down to communicate with us individually, as he often did. For example, in the book of Genesis, Cain was about to do harm to his brother, and God intervened. God, the God of high God of heaven and earth, came directly to Cain and had a discussion with him, tried to persuade him to get out of this murderous spirit. The same God came to Pharaoh in dreams. He came to King Nebuchadnezzar. He's going to come, rather, to King Nebuchadnezzar in Babylon through dreams. Even part of the Bible will be written by King Nebuchadnezzar, Daniel chapter 4. The Lord comes close to people, even the heathen. He comes directly to people to try to redeem them as individual souls. This is exactly, of course, what God has been trying to do with Jehoiakim. He's coming to him through his prophet, through his servant, and now we have this situation. You know, how different things might have been if Jehoiakim had obeyed the Bible. What am I talking about? I'm talking about Deuteronomy 17, starting at verse 16. And what were the kings of Judah supposed to do? Deuteronomy 17, verses 16 to 20 will tell us. Jehoiakim had an opportunity, and here's his opportunity. When God would set a king over his people, that king was supposed to get his own copy of the word of God and work on it all the time. Listen, starting at verse 16, but he shall not multiply horses for himself, nor cause the people to return to Egypt to multiply horses. For the Lord has said to you, you shall not return that way again. Neither shall he multiply wives for himself, lest his heart turn away, nor shall he greatly multiply silver and gold for himself. Also, it shall be when he sits on the throne of his kingdom that he shall write for himself a copy of this law in a book from the one before the priests and the Levites, and it shall be with him, and he shall read it all the days of his life, that he may learn to fear the Lord his God and be careful to observe all the words of this law and these statutes, that his heart may not be lifted above his brethren, that he may not turn aside from the commandment to the right hand or to the left, and that he may prolong his days in his kingdom, he and his children in the midst of Israel. Jehoiakim could have done that, should have done that. Might have been a different man if he'd have done that. Would have been a different man if he had done that. Didn't do it. You know what? If we read the word of God, we will be different people. Jehoiakim is a very sad story. God's word changes us. No wonder Satan absolutely hates it to his core. Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, we thank you for your word. We pray that you'll help us to love it more. We know this will give the devil's fits and a rash, and good. Lord, may they have lots of rash. Bless us, Lord, we pray, by changing our hearts through your word. Draw us close to your heart by the blood of Jesus, Lord. Revise us. May your word not come back to you empty. Help us, Lord, to be as right with you as Jehoiakim sadly was wrong. Thank you for hearing our prayer, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. So how did this all turn out? Well, God pronounced through his prophet the doom of Jehoiakim, and then the whole scroll was rewritten with many more like such words. And so there we have it. You can't ditch God's word and just expect you're going to get away with it. The Lord be with you today, and may some of these words be in my heart and mind and in your heart and mind.